In today's daily challenge, we have to accept an integer n as the input, and then the program must print the count of unique pairs that can be formed using the digits of n except the unit digit, where the sum of digit in each pair is equal to the unit digit of n. And if there is no such pair, then the program must print -1 as the output. So let us see the sample input 1. So this is the value of n, and our expected output is 3. Let us see how we are getting the value 3 as the output. For this integer n, the unit digit is 8, and all the remaining digit except the unit digit are these. So now our task is to use all these digits and create pairs such that their sum is equal to 8. Given in the question, these are all the pairs that can be formed such that their sum is equal to 8. So 2 plus 6 is 8, and 4 plus 4 is 8, 5 plus 3 is 8. But the problem that we would be facing while counting the pairs is, we would also be counting the pairs 6, 2, because they also have the sum 8. The only difference is their positions are interchanged. But we already have a pair 2, 6. So the pair 2, 6 and 6, 2 has the sum 8, but the only difference is their positions are interchanged. So in order to avoid counting of the pair 6, 2, we are going to use the absolute difference as the key factor, because we can see that the only common thing between the pairs 2, 6 and 6, 2 is their absolute difference. Both have the absolute difference same, that is 4. So whenever we are finding a pair, we are going to store the absolute difference in a separate array. And whenever we find another new pair whose sum is equal to the unit digit, we are going to check whether the absolute difference of the new pair is already present in the array or not. And only when the absolute difference of the newly formed pair is not present in the array, we are going to count it. So this is the logic. And let us see how to implement this logic. So this is the program which I have written in C language. Initially, I have declared some variables, and then I have declared an unsigned long integer, as it is given in the question that the value of n can be up to 10 power 16. In the next line, I am accepting the value of n. And then I have declared another two arrays named ARR and differences. In this array ARR, we would be storing the digits of the integer n, and in this array differences, we would be storing the absolute differences of the unique pairs, and then storing the value of unit digit of the integer n using the modulo operator. And then I am dividing the value by n, because now we don't need the unit digit. And here, using a while loop, we are storing all the remaining digits that are present in the integer n into the array ARR. The actual logic for counting the pairs start here. So this nested for loop takes an element in the array and add it with every element present in the array next to it. And whenever two elements added has the sum same as the unit digit, then it means that a new pair has been found. And whenever a new pair is found, we have to check whether the absolute difference of the values is present in the differences array or not. If the absolute difference of the values is present in the differences array, then it is a duplicate pair. We have also declared a variable here named f. And when this condition is satisfied, we would be updating the value of f is equal to 1. And after the execution of this for loop, if the value of f is still equal to 0, then it is a new pair. In that case, we are incrementing the count value and adding the absolute difference of it to the differences array, since a duplicate pair for this particular pair should not be added. And finally, if the value of flag is equal to 0, it means that there is no pairs. Else, we are just going to print the value of the count. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. So first, I am going to give the sample input 1, and our expected output is 3. So we are also getting 3 as the output. Now for the sample input 2, our expected output is minus 1. And hence we are also getting minus 1 as the output. So for the sample input 3, our expected output is 1. And we are also getting minus 1 as the output. So thank you for watching.